for anyone that's worked on a service desk, you realize there's a lot of moving parts, a lot of things coming in, a lot of support going out, and it can get complex. But one of the ways to cut through a lot of that complexity is to use dashboards. A lot of people think dashboards are just for your management or your other stakeholders, but it really can help the individual technician. Keeps you on top of the type of incidents that are coming in, the ones that are assigned to you, the specific work types, and all manner of things. And the great part about it is you can actually design them for your needs. And then if that happens to meet the needs of other team members, you can share them. So I'm going to show you how to do all of that in SolarWinds Service Desk. Now, this is an example of a perfectly workable dashboard, but maybe it's not perfect for me. What's nice is we can take this as a kind of jumping off point and then customize it for our needs. So we'll just start simple. For instance, if my team and I are only responsible for applications, then all this extra information in incidents is unnecessary. So we can edit that. Just go to edit, put on a filter. Select category, applications, and update. So in just a few clicks, I know that me and my team are responsible for exactly 45 application incidents. But let's say none of the widgets on your dashboard really meet your needs. It's easy enough. You can just build one from blank. All you do is go up to Add Widget, and for the type, it's all the way at the bottom, select Blank Widget, and then fill this out for our specific needs. In this case, I'm going to say I want a responsive font size, it's for incidents, and I want these grouped by did you restart? And I'm just going to keep it as the default pie chart. And there we go. Of all the incidents that have come in, 13 people have restarted and 461 have not. Looks like that's part of the problem. But again, this is for everybody. This is not just for my team. So I can go and add a filter to this. Unfortunately, in my situation, it looks like all 89 incidents, no one rebooted before they contacted us. But such is life on a service desk. So this is a great start, but if you're displaying this somewhere on a board or a second screen, or you want to share it out to your execs, maybe having the sizing here isn't quite exactly what you want. Maybe you need more information and detail about certain things and less about other ones. What's nice is this is a fully responsive layout. You can easily grab the corner, make them larger, make them smaller, fit your desired layout, and then if you don't love where it is, you can just grab it and move other widgets around it. It really is that simple to build a dashboard that's specific to your needs. Now, I'm happy with this dashboard, but this is all about incidents. Maybe I want one about problems because the two go hand in hand. That's easy enough to do. Let's go ahead and save this one first. Starting with a blank dashboard, you can just add whatever widget you need. Maybe I need my top problem tags, maybe my changes. And for symmetry, let's go ahead and put change tags in as well. Rearrange as I like. Save this one. Now, since I built this particular dashboard all about me and my team and our incidents, maybe I want to make sure all of my other teammates have it as well. So I can just hit the ellipsis, share, and I can send it to a specific individual. Or to an entire group. And that's it. Now it's shared with them. So they can go into their dashboards and select the dropdown and see it listed there. So I know we really just kind of scratched the surface of dashboards in SolarWinds Service Desk, but I hope I've given you an idea about how you can customize them to make sure that you and your team work better.